part two and pick up where we left off. 5101, I can't make the turn. I have to back up.
5101, heading inbound.
Hey, how can I help?
So, I was trying to do a courtesy stop for a customer, and I wasn't making my turn as I normally would, and so now I have to back up in order to make this really tight turn, or else I'm going to hit some bushes. I just wanted you to know that I have to put it in reverse. I'm going to go out and make sure that I can see how much space I have, and I'll go very slowly. But, I don't see any other option besides going in reverse.
Okay. First off, if you're not comfortable, I can send a supervisor up there. Are you blocking the intersection?
I am blocking the intersection, but it's a very low travel intersection.
Okay. Well, just I don't want you to do anything you feel unsafe with. And then always remember with courtesy stops that, you know, safety is first. And if you're not able to do it, that's fine.
Yeah, I should have just told the lady no. I'm sorry.
No, you don't have to be sorry. I'm sorry to me. I just don't want you to be in frustrating situations for you, you know? So, you let me know. If you're okay getting yourself out, that's fine. If you feel like you need help, let me know.
Can I have you stay on the line for a second while I go outside and just look at how much room I have and such?
Everything's okay?
Yes, all good. I was about to send it ready for service. Sorry about that.
No, no worries. All right, well, thank you.
Yeah, just go and look. That's all you got to do. Okay, no big deal. Okay, another one. 27. Another one. How many of these are we having in one day here?
2071. I got a guy yelling and screaming, and he won't sit down. He won't get off the bus.
All right, 2071, I copy. Give me a quick description, age, right, race, height.
About 5'2", 5'5", somewhere in there. Black male, short hair, black shirt, gray pants. He's got a sticker on his arm from COVID testing. Short beard, mustache, short mustache. And he's standing right next to me here, and I'm feeling really uncomfortable.
All right, have your doors open. I don't know if you can hear me or not, but we are on the phone, please. And 2071, he's still there?
Yeah, I am. He's standing right here. He's not getting up. He's not complaining at all.
All right. We're on the phone, police, right now. So just stay on the line. Do you see any sign of weapons?
No, I do not. Not at this time, but he was right up in my face. I had to push my door all the way closed. It was really uncomfortable.
Okay. Where is he now? Is he still in your face?
He's wandering around back and forth up the front and back of the bus. He's dumping stuff out. He's just making a mess. He's kind of mumbling to himself with his mouth closed.
Okay. We'll keep the doors open. Is he bothered any other passengers?
Negative. He hasn't seemed to have been bugging anybody else. He just all of a sudden just jumped up, started yelling and screaming, and then now he's just kind of wandering around. He doesn't seem to be coherent or listening to anything I'm saying to him at all.
Okay. All right. Well, I don't want you to hang up with me, but police should be en route as well as the supervisor, so I'll stay on line with you. And Jessica, you said he was 5'2", a black...
Okay, he's going to get off. I can see the call.
Rock Creek, DCC.
2071, vehicle 3252. Has got somebody harassing him right in their face. We're sending police. They're on Southwest Hall.
All right, we're in here. They're here. They get off. See? And he got off.
2071, he just got off the bus just now.
All right, I copy. Your doors are closed.
Second, his foot hit the sidewalk, yep.
Okay. And Do you feel safe to roll? Do you still want to talk to police?
I do not, but the police should come check this guy out. He's kind of wandering around here in front of these restaurants and such. And he seems like he could be violent.
Okay, well, go ahead and roll. And I will update police if you need anything else.
Go ahead and roll. And here's the famous Rip City, Donald Trump with his Confederate flag sticker. Moronavirus. Moronavirus, I like that. And then you've gone back to the Rip City profile page. Okay, buddy boy. Okay, 1901 has a three-way split and no more tape for fares.
1901, how can I help you? This is the second bus I'm using, so this morning I have a triple split today. So I used my roll that I brought with me this morning on the previous bus, and this bus just ran out of paper, and I don't have another roll. I was wondering if you can have a supervisor meet me with a roll, or I can just do a free ride. Up to you.
Why don't you just do a free ride? There you go, buddy.
Yeah, get a free ride once that runs out.
There you go, free ride. All right, that verbal, just go dump them in a ditch. Uh-oh. Oh, boy. Yeah, okay. Where is it? Oh, fuck. Where are we? Okay, yeah. It's going to play on computer.
1268, Fitz Morrison.
Hello, 1268. I got your loud verbal. What's going on?
Yes, I have a homeless guy that I've had problems with before get on the bus. He's really dirty, biohazard.
He's dirty.
And he's kind of threatened me. He's like standing up by me, pointing at me, telling me I'm going to get it. And I would like him on my bus. I don't feel safe. I've already had two customers walk off the bus because of him.
Yeah, get him out of there. Get him
in the
ditch.
So the supervisor can come meet up with you?
Yep.
Guess you can't ignore him.
Okay, hold there, please. I think the supervisor's pretty close. And just they're ready for service when they come and assist you.
He's in the ditch.
All righty, will do. Thanks.
There's
Thank
the ditch.
You.
1031. Wow. No, that's not the one I want. I don't want that one. No. Time for that. Hold on. 5271, sleeper.
5271, got a sleeper.
Okay, he just won't get off.
No, he's sound asleep, I think.
Okay, have you gone to the outside of the bus and banged on the window with your keys or something?
I did it on the handrail, but I can go outside and do something. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sometimes that helps them. Mm-hmm. I'll see if we have a supervisor there. I think I see a rail supervisor vehicle there, but I'll see if we have a bus one there.
Yeah, I just drove by the bus one.
Okay. Mm-hmm. We'll get them right over there. Mm-hmm.
Okay, fire in Tigard. Oh, shit. We're having problems on computer one. Yeah, I'm gonna take that back. Yeah, it's running slow. Yeah, we're running slow. Take it back. Take it back. It's not running. It's still... Okay, so... So it didn't load on computer two. So are we in a shutdown here? I don't know, maybe turn something off. Let's try this one. The scanner's not working. It's currently not working. All right, well, we have a scanner shutdown here. Let's try this one. Oh, here it goes. That one's working.
Hello, 93627. Did the police show up there?
Thank you. Did I say 96? I'm at 9367. Yes, they are there. They are talking to the gentleman. And I've left already.
Perfect. I just want to make sure that they got there. You know, worry about the cleaners being there with someone like that. And I'm glad that you called that in. And I did send you an asset number to write a report since we did call police about the incident and you had to use your fire extinguisher. We just need to document all of that. So did you get that on your CAD?
I sure did. Thank you for that. And I've got one with the other passenger that saw him. I think he said he got some cell phone video because he thought he was going to be attacked, actually. So I'll try and get his information also.
Yeah, that would be great in case the police call in and, you know, want further information. All the information we can collect is fantastic. So thank you for calling it in. Remember to write the work card so they can replace your fire extinguisher, please. And I hope you have a great rest of your day.
Thank you. You too. Have a great weekend.
Thank you. You also. We'll be clear at 10:51.
All right. Now, here we go. Let's go back and see if this works. Oh, yeah, it's working out.
1268. Fifth Morrison.
Go in the ditch.
Hello, 1268. I got your loud verbal. What's going on?
Yes, I have a homeless guy that I've had problems.
We just heard that. Okay. Fire at Tiger TC.
9367 at Tiger Transit Center.
Mm. Hello, 9367. How can I help you?
Okay. Well, I'm at my layover here, and the cleaners.
Yeah.
As I'm getting off my bus, pointed to me and said, hey, there's smoke coming out of that trash can. So I used my fire extinguisher on it and put the fire out. But they and another passenger intending to board told me we're looking at that particular gentleman here who had been threatening to set the fire on purpose. So I'm just letting you know, I put the fire out so there's nothing. No reason to, it's, you know, it's, that part of it's taken care of, but I just thought it for me that there's someone who people are saying he does not have good intentions right here.
Okay, and that person is still there. Can you give me a description of them, please?
Sure, he's, white man.
All right, we don't need to hear the whole thing. Okay, supervisor threw him off.
1268, I've had 6 of them.
Alright, 1268, the passenger's off your bus?
Yeah, he got off once supervisor came.
Put him in a ditch.
Alright, I copy. We'll go ahead and roll.
They deserve the ditch.
I hope you have a better day.
Alrighty, thank you.
Thank you, 1037.
No, I've never been treated to the three-way split. Nope. So now this fat pig is in the hospital, too. He has a slight fever. I don't know, man. I think you're better off out of the hospital. I don't trust hospitals. Of course, they've got the best care because they're part of the oligarchy. They're part of the functionary of the oligarchy. So they're going to get goddamn the best care, which none of us here in serfdom can get. 1407 Needles.
Okay, I copy. 14. Outbound needles and garbage.
Needles and garbage.
If the supervisor can go pick up those needles.
And garbage.
Thank you for letting us know. You're welcome.
Pick up those garbage.
Have a good rest of your day. We'll be there at 10:53.
Oh, headache. Too much drinking. You know, I watch this movie. You know, if I get a real depressing movie anymore, my mornings are movie time. You know, I wake up. Very slowly. I'm very hard to wake up. But when I finally do wake up, which takes me about an hour from when I wake up to when I actually can do anything, I put on a movie. I watch movies in the morning every morning. And I watch this movie about this guy who was a Nazi. He was a German Catholic, and he didn't. He refused to serve Hitler on religious grounds, and he was guillotined by the Nazis because he wouldn't serve Hitler. And the Catholic Church has beatified him, you know, the step before a saint. He was a, I don't know what you call it, but the beatify, is that what the word is? I'm not sure. Let me see. Beatify meaning. Okay. Beatification. He's a saint. Roman Catholic declared. He was declared one of the blessed. And that was a story that made me drink. Shouldn't drink. Okay. Kill them all. Bring out the ditch.
1407 outbound 50th and Lincoln.
Hello, 1407. I got another report hazard from you and a request to talk. How can I help you?
The request to talk was just the same thing. I didn't know if you guys would see it and think it was the one that I was reporting earlier and that I like duplicated it. At Chavez outbound on Chavez at the shelter. There is a white male, hard to say how old he is, I would say in his 30s, kind of heavy set, dressed all in black shorts, black jacket, he's got a hood on, but he's got greeny hair, and he's got, his face is all, I don't know if it's tattoos, but he's got, like, black around his eyes. Anyway, he's sitting there with a six-pack, and drinking some beer, some pale ale, and harassing female passengers that are trying to board.
Yes, yes,
I
yes.
Copy.
And they're not going to do anything about it, okay? Good luck. You don't like him, but he has a right to sit on the goddamn bench. They'll tell him to go off, and he'll come back. All right, 7248, I think he's lost. Wants to go to the sheriff.
7248.
Hello, 7248. How can I help you?
I have an elderly gentleman. He's blind, 88. He keeps on the bus like he's lost. He keeps telling me he want to go to the sheriff's department. The sheriff's department on 82nd. And that's all he keeps saying. So it might need like a supervisor or somebody to come get him and try to assist on where he's going. I don't have a clue.
I copy. Have you asked him if he has an address or anything of the place that he wants to go?
Yeah, I keep asking him that. He just always says the sheriff's department. That tells me nothing.
I copy. Well, if he's still on your bus when you get closer to Clackamas, just give us another call so we can try to have a supervisor meet up with him over there and see if we can figure out where he needs to go.
Okay, all right, will do. Thank you.
That's the guy that gave Lane Jensen.
Thank you. At 1207.
I restarted the web server to help. Okay. What you got here? There are no safeguards against... What's this? There are no safeguards against investigation interference at Metro. Metro protocols don't ensure investigations occur fully independent from employees involved. Well, of course not. They're corrupt. I know that. Everything is corrupt. I'm already aware of the corruption of everything. Okay? Thank you, Jason. 7248. Oh, I just did that. Okay. Just did that. Victor Scanner Star next.
2068.
We love Victor.
2068, go ahead. So, are we now accepting police officers' business cards as a... Huh?
Well, yeah, who the fuck cares, stupid idiot? What are you...
negative, no. Well, somebody said they've been riding all day along with that. I told them, I said, well, as far as I know, we don't accept those. Didn't give me a hard time or anything, but they just got off the bus. But I just said, I didn't tell them no or anything. I just said, as far as I know, we don't...
You didn't tell them no or anything, but you had to make an issue out of it. So there you go, Victor Superstar. You could have just said, who cares, and don't bring it up and don't even think about it. But you could have done that, but I know you're a Victor superstar.
We don't recognize those here on the system.
Okay, Victor, you pulled
that. That is correct. All right, thank you.
Oh, okay, we're still going.
You're welcome.
Okay, Victor. Okay, we're still going here. What do we got here? Yeah. People running through the Streel bars at Hawthorne.
Hey, 1412, it's Lisa. How can I help you? Hey, Lisa, I don't know if any other drivers are having problems with the Hawthorne Bridge and people running across it through them steel bars. What? But the last couple nights and even throughout some other days, when I'm going down there between 1105, crossing over it into downtown and then coming back out of it, we've got like 3 to 5 people crossing through them bars. And this last time, a couple of the girls, I just made a wilder guess thinking they could be prostitutes with a pimp, because that's kind of what they were dressed like. And then they flashed me coming back across with their asses. And then there's 2 businessmen standing on the side watching the last couple of nights also at the same time. And I don't know who they are or if they have anything to do with this, but they stand on the east side going back out of town. And so I don't know. They're just standing there watching.
All right, well, there's not much we can do about it. They're not on TriMet property. So just make sure, remember, when you're using, well, at all times, make sure you're just using extreme caution. People are extremely unpredictable.
Oh, yes, and very troublesome people.
Yeah, very troublesome.
I'll put my brights on and kind of honk my horn and make sure they know where how close I am when they're doing this, jumping out front of me like that. All right, thank you.
All right, well, just remember, you legally use your bright lights in the city, okay? So I would not recommend
those. Who is that? Who is that?
Horn a little tap so that they know that you're there.
What do you mean, to illegal?
No, I did not know using your bright lights was illegal. All right.
I never heard that.
Yeah, 2354.
Since when is using your bright lights illegal? I never heard anything like that. Lisa, my love, I have no idea what you're talking about.
Hey, Monique, it's Lisa. Monique, how can I help you?
Lisa, my love. Hey, if the bus that's leaving Gresham Transit Center right now that's deadheading wants to bring their passengers to me, I will take them and they can transfer them to me.
I have no idea what you're talking about. What are you talking about?
Oh, usually I leave the transit center like up to 8 minutes late on my last run back into town, because I try and get everybody's buses that come in. And today I thought I got all the buses that were in because I thought they were all there. But nope, they were coming in late, later than usual. And so I missed the last bus.
Okay. I'm sure if she had somebody, she would have called, because she probably would have just brought him down with her. That's the kind of driver she is. She's right behind you now, so go ahead and roll. She's going down Powell. If she has them, it's good.
Okay, yeah. I gotta see if I can't fix this on the other end. Usually I wait. So, they're really great kids. So, I gotta get this out.
Okay. 404, I'm on the dead pad and there's a passenger. Oh my god.
Hey, 404, this is Lisa. I got a request to talk, or was that a ready for service?
No, that was a request to talk. I'm on my deadhead back to the garage, and I didn't realize that there was a passenger on the back of the bus that missed the last stop. They're wanting to go back to North Portland. I'm curious if they're possibly
be taking alternative to head back,
or what's the protocol at this point?
Definitely, if you're okay, take them back. Just turn around there at Montgomery Park and go back the way you just came. Do you know where you are, how to turn yourself around? If you turn right on Nikolai there, that'll take you over back on the Yeon. Yeah, you can take I-5 north, you mean? Like, take that exit? Or the I-5 south, is that what you mean?
Beautiful.
Yeah, I-5 north, probably like the Alberta exit.
Yeah, you can do that. You can take the Lombard exit and drop them off at Interstate and Lombard there and come back that way, like right by the Fred Meyer's there.
Copy. Okay. I just want to check the fellas allowed. Okay. Thank you.
Yep. And in the future, this is why we ask you to clear your bus at the end of the line, okay? I was a driver for years. I did the
same
thing.
Yeah, you dumbass.
I
didn't clear
them the list because I brought people back. So please clear your bus at the end of the line, okay?
Will do. Copy. Thank you.
Okay, 2336.
Small bus bridge?
All right. Stand by for now. 9120.
9120. I'm at North Terminal. I'm probably close to what you need me for.
We're about to do a bus bridge, small bus bridge with only two buses, from First and Oak to Rose Quarter. I've got one at North Terminal. So let's have them. Are they there with you?
I don't know. I'm sitting in my vehicle filling out this report, so I didn't go inside yet. So they probably are. I did see buses out here.
All right, we're about to have them head over to First and Oak, and then I've got one that's going to be coming from Park Rose, and I'm going to have them head over to Rose Quarter.
I don't know, one goddamn bus bridge. What a great system they got here. Small buses.
All right, I'll find the operator here, and I'm sure they've heard this conversation, but I'll find them and tell them... what's going on? Thank you.
I'm calling them now.
Okay. Yeah. First and Oak to Rose Quarter.
How do you get ahead of that? First and Oak to Rose Quarter and what?
First and Oak to Rose Quarter and then Rose Quarter back to First and Oak. It's just a complete circle.
Copy that.
2336. An extra 735?
735, I copy. Rose Quarter to First and Oak.
You got it. Thank you. 2336.
Alrighty, and now we get gentlemen fighting.
This is 868 on the OHSU stop outbound. I got two gentlemen that are fighting on my bus.
Cool. Okay, John, are you stopped with your doors open?
Yes, I am. I'm stopped with my doors open. They seem to be sitting down now, but I don't know if they're going to start again.
All right, are you comfortable telling them that you either need to knock it off and behave or get off the bus? Are you comfortable saying something to that effect?
Let me try to talk to them and see if they'll cooperate. If they won't, I'll let you know.
All right, I'm standing right.
You have to try. You know my method. Part two.
Okay, well, it sounds like we're going to roll.
All right, well, that didn't sound like they're calming down.
Yes, I agree with you. What would be your recommendation?
Yeah.
I would recommend tying it up there, and I can call either campus security, police, and or supervisor, or all three. And you can tell them that. Say police are en route. They one or both of you need to get off the bus. That's what I would tell them.
Okay, I just had one come up and talk to me. It looks like they're going to calm down, so I'm going to roll.
Okay, if they can stay separate on the bus and behave, go ahead, and if you have any more incidents, just call me tied up and call me again priority.
I will. Thanks for your help. I appreciate it.
All right, John. 2251.
Yeah, I'm drinking again. Why don't you tell the whole world, okay? Al is drinking. So what? I can do what I want to do. I'm retired. I don't care. All right, yeah, okay, so, is this still going?
Hey, I'm afraid they backed it up again. This is 868 again. I'm at 6th and Sheridan.
Okay, you going to tie it up there and tell them to get off the bus?
I'm going to tie it up here and send whoever you can send. I had a guy get on the bus, and now he's trying to get involved.
Send somebody.
Okay, do you see anything that they can use as weapons, and can you give me a description of them?
Yeah, I got three guys. One guy's wearing a green shirt and a red shirt, a green jacket. He has silver hair, probably mid-40s, about 6 foot. The other guy he's into it with is a black guy, about 5'9". Heavy set. He works for the Veterans Administration. He's a regular.
Okay, I'm on the phone with 911, okay? Can we get off here, but let me know.
I sure will. I don't think we can roll any farther. I thought they could behave themselves, but they can't.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you give me a description of the third guy?
Come on.
You know, I opened the door because one of the guys wanted to get off, and he's a homeless guy that's sitting at the bench over here. He just got off the bus, and he's sitting down.
What? Did he actually say that?
I'm sorry.
Stay with me. I'm on the phone with 911.
Okay, thanks. I appreciate your help. I'm in a real narrow stretch of the road. I'm off to the side, but there's hardly any traffic here, so I think I'll be okay. They both ended up pushing each other up all the way to the front of the bus, so I just pulled over as soon as I could.
All right, you're fine there. Stay there. John, what color clothing does the black male wearing?
He's got a tan shirt with black pants and black tennis shoes.
I'm having fun on that bus.
All right, I copy.
Ride, try me.
Interesting
people. It's a great system. You're going to love riding it. It's just fun. Oh, and look, 1518, some guy threatening. Jesus. Who needs hazard pay when you...
1518.
Jesus.
Hey, John, it's Lisa. How can I help you?
Yeah, Lisa, I was talking to a different dispatcher earlier. There's some guy following me and threatening me, and he got off the bus at Thurman and 27, and he just tried to get on again at 23rd and Thurman. So I know there's a message out to be on the lookout for this guy, but he's on 23rd. He's on 23rd now, heading southbound and trying to get on buses.
Okay. Yeah, and it is recorded that you denied him service because of what happened earlier, and that's just fine. We want you to be safe.
Copy that. I just want everybody to know that this guy's out here, and he's trouble.
He's trouble.
All right. Thank you. I hope the rest of your night is uneventful.
Thanks. Me too. 1518. Over and out.
This is B-6-1. Well, okay, we're having a great scanner time. I think that's it, man. That's it. Looks like you got them all. Up to 2,230 minutes. And that will do it for my coverage. That's 32 minutes. That was an hour of calls today.